RSACs is usually diagnosed around the age of between 2 and 6. Children have a clumsy walk. They tend to fall more. Then they go through all types of tests. And at the end, we find out that they are stiff. They are less coordinated. And with time, they will get problems with strength in their feet, in their hands. And all that will lead to a loss of walking in their 40s. And the end of life is not pretty. And it's even more difficult for those patients because they're cognitively normal. So they just see their body as a machine not functioning properly from the start and deteriorating while they are in full control intellectually.
We did see changes in the neurons. In fact, we saw two major changes. One is we see a change in the morphology of the neurons, the structure of the neurons. In particular, because the mitochondria are not being transported into the processes themselves don't seem to develop properly or don't seem to form properly. Mitochondria have multiple functions in cells, but their main function is that they're the cellular powerhouse. They're the organelle that generates ATP, which is the source of cellular energy for all cells. The second major change we saw was neuronal death, which of course is important. This is a neurodegenerative disease. It progresses over time, it gets worse over time, and we saw degeneration of neurons that was age dependent. In young mice, the neurons looked fine, but by the time we got to older mice, we would start to see the death of neurons in particular regions of the brain, notably the cerebellum, which is the region that's involved in controlling motor function. The fact that the saxin protein, the protein encoded by the disease gene, localizes to mitochondria indicates to us that it has a mitochondrial function. And that was a big surprise to us.
RSACs is a founder effect. What it means is that we have more in Quebec because of the arrival of about 10,000 French founder in the Nouvelle France, so New France, introduced a mutation. And a lot of people in Quebec have inherited that mutation. And when they decide to have children, then increase the risk of that disease. And that's why, in particular in Saguenay-Lac-Saint-Jean, 1 in 21 people carry this error, this common error, and that's why there's so many of those cases in Quebec compared to other places in the world.
In January 2006, we have a diagnosis that our oldest kid, which is now eight years old, he was at that time in 2006, almost three, has the sickness. So after the shock, which was in January, we decide around March and April to start the foundation, and then we start contacting some, you know, researcher and doctors to try to see how we're going to proceed to start the research ASAP.
You know, our children are young, it's an evolving neurological condition, so if we don't do anything about it, things will be as is now. That's not what we hope for. We hope that, you know, we can start research here in Montreal. We know there are great institutions that conduct here research. And we created the foundation with a board of directors, with a scientific board also to review what's being done. And now there's like 30 people working actively on trying to find a treatment or to stop the evolution of the disease.
Now, this is an important a moment for us, for as a team, and for the patients and their family, because for the first time we have insight as to what is not functioning in their brain, and therefore we can think of how maybe to make it better.
This is something that's really kind of neat about this. What we found is that there's been a real emergence in the neurodegenerative field. So there's large numbers of labs around the world studying major neurodegenerative diseases such as Parkinson's disease, amyotrophic lateral sclerosis, Huntington's disease, and Alzheimer's disease, all forms of neurodegenerative disease. And something that's emerged from that work is that dysfunction in mitochondria is a common theme in those diseases.
It's related to other neurological diseases that are well known throughout the world and affect many people. This is a great news. This is what we've always hoped for, is that, you know, some discoveries in other related, or sometimes it's even, I guess, non-related, that's what science sometimes teaches us, is that even in unrelated diseases, it can help find a solution to the diseases we're working on. So this is great news, and we really want to thank the research team here in Quebec.
No, you just had the 2D.